Hi everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to solve the error type error configuration is not a constructor in OpenAI. So I think most probably you'll be getting this error when you try to use the OpenAI API with Node.js. So first let me explain you what is causing the issue and later I will give a solution for this. So the reason why we are getting this error because OpenAI package has been upgraded. Its version is now 4 and this code applies for OpenAI version 3. So OpenAI version 4 doesn't accept this kind of code, okay? Doesn't have configuration and these things. So if you go to package.json, you'll be having here OpenAI 4.2. So for this purpose, we need to have a slight different code, okay? We will be using most of the things common, but there is a slight change in code. So first thing what you can do is, you can just comment this code, okay? We don't need this code, you can comment or delete it out. I think commenting is better because we will be using like copy pasting stuff from here. So I think it's better to comment. So after you're commenting it, next thing, just go to Google and you need to type OpenAI migration guide, okay? And at the first, you'll be having a GitHub link, which says V3 to V4, which is our OpenAI package version. So if you just go through that, we'll be having all the necessary things to upgrade. So first thing is, let's start from initialization or import. So this is the old way, okay? We are doing this, but this won't work. And for that, we need to use the new way. So I'll just go with the new way. I'll just copy this and I'm just gonna go and paste it over here. But since I'm using this in Node.js, I can't import this way, right? We need to use the require thing. So I'll just copy this require thing and I'll just come here. It's going to be const OpenAI equal require OpenAI. And you need to use the same variable name here also. And next thing, I need to copy my API key. Okay, I'll just copy this. And I'm just pasting it here within double quotes. And you can just remove this comment. Yeah. So now we are good with the import. Next thing, we need to have our configuration of model and the messages that we are going to write. Okay. So for that, same thing. If you just scroll down, and here we'll be having the old one where we use the create chat completion. But now we will be having this dot. We are just adding dots and just separating the word. So for this same thing, we can just copy this and I'll go here and paste it. So we are good now. The same constant variable name should come here and model is fine. And rather than having hello, I will just go with essay on Ronaldo. Okay, and another important thing that I would recommend you to add is the max tokens, okay? So you can just scroll down and here you'll be having this max tokens thing. You can just copy this. So to avoid wastage of tokens, okay? Because in case if you're doing some testing purposes, you can just avoid tokens being wasted. So I'll just go here. It's going to be max underscore tokens. So this basically limits our response that we get from OpenAI API. So in case if you're using, you will have a token count. In case if you are using a free or paid version, whatever it is, based upon the tokens that you use, you are going to get charged. The number of credits are going to get taken away. So in case if you add this property, you can get a minimized response in case if you're using for any test purposes. So I'll just go with 30 or 40. That is fine for testing purposes. So this is now good. And final thing is we need to have this code inside a async function because here we have used await. So I'll just go here and type const. I'll just go with open function, something like this. And this is going to be async. Just have an arrow function there. Yeah, now we are good. And let me just now call this function here itself. I haven't created any routes over here. So I'm just like directly declaring and initializing the function in the same thing. Yeah, I'm just calling it right over here. So this is the code, guys. If you want, you can just pause and type it. And you need to add here your own API key, okay? Yeah, this is good. And let me just now run this node filename.js. So here you can see I am getting a response. I'm getting role and content. So this works. And if I increase the tokens, let me go with, I'll go with say 100. And rather than having this as a JSON, I will directly go with the content. So for that, you can just have here dot content. Yeah, and you need to have this thing, okay? So I'm just consoling this thing. If you want to console and view this, you need to have this. So I'm just saving it, and this time we will be getting an better response with more words because I have increased the token count. So it will be like twice the response that we already got. Twice. Yeah, so here you can see I'm getting directly the text because I'm directly accessing the content thing. So this is how you solve this issue, guys. I hope you would have found this video useful. Mine's a programming channel. Do check the playlist. I've done a lot of thread operations using MySQL, MongoDB and Spring Boot Node.js. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.